You know, behind every big plan, there is, of course, a big brain. That's right, a big head. And in this moment, right now, we're going to get a chance to talk to Glenn about the masterminding of a great plan down here at 3R. All right. So now, if I was going to ask you, what do you guys do? What are you going to tell me? What do you do, Glenn?
We're a small recycler, and we're kind of a multi-purpose company. We do repair work, we do IT work, and we also have a recycling operation for our client base. And we're a small recycler. We do stuff by hand. We're old-fashioned, old-tech kind of in a way. But we simply don't have the large equipment. But we deal with other recyclers that do. So we basically get equipment in here. We separate it out. We just distinguish ourselves really in two ways. We do pickup services, which a lot of companies don't do. And we also try to do as much reuse and donation as we can. And we're pretty aggressive about that, which is good because it just means that we're getting more product out there. It means people can repair stuff they already have. People are less likely to buy new stuff. And that kind of overall helps environmentally speaking. And then we use other recyclers that are doing the large scale operations, which is what they're good at. So Total Reclaim is one that we work with quite a bit, and they're great. And we take from a lot of the equipment that needs automation, needs machinery to take apart. So that's pretty much what we do. Most people, I think, don't really know where to go. Once they find out, it's like this great revelation, and they're establishing that connection. So they're able to come to us again and again, or they call us up and say, hey, we got more equipment for you to pick up. So it's almost like a sense of relief, because it's just stuff piled up that they can't do anything with if
whole
they don't
rooms.
Know how to. Yeah.
Whole rooms worth
yeah,
of
and
stuff.
Yeah, and they want to deal with it in a responsible manner. But again, it's getting the word out, and King County's doing a good job of it. We're trying to do as much as we can to get out there through email. Not aggressive marketing, but basically just letting people know that we're here.
Right.
Partnering up with nonprofits, doing things to benefit them, doing donations, doing all sorts of things that basically get out in the community and kind of get the word out. So everybody's chipping in. And if you're wondering about what to do too, to support recycling, not only can you recycle your stuff responsibly, but hey, if you just, you know, can repair a machine rather than buy a new one, look into that option, because that's a great way to go and it helps out everybody. It's kind of a win-win situation. We are a small community of people that, you know, all know each other in Seattle. So I think it's great because you can meet people and find great resources, whether it's somebody working for you or somebody you might partner up with something, you know, there's a lot of great dynamic there. But yeah, I really want to build a company. We're really small. I don't intend to be a big company, but it's nice to have a few people to help out and have it grow and make a few jobs and all that. And I like to work with people I like to work with, and everybody gets along, and I think we're a great team. So it makes a lot more fun if you can do that. This warehouse facility is at 1920 Occidental Avenue South, 8:30 to 5:30, Monday through Friday, 10 to 2 on Saturdays. But call, we have some flexibility in our hours. We like people to call ahead, schedule an appointment, or at least let us know when they're coming. And we're doing large drop-offs and pickups of equipment from corporations and nonprofits. You can bring it down here, or you can call us, and we can come and pick it up for you.
That is awesome.
Yeah. So and people tend to like that service because they don't have the resources or the manpower a lot of times to handle that, especially if they're a small business and they've accumulated 20 or 30 things. And they don't want to drive down to four separate cars.
You know, it's like go get a truck all day. Yeah. Wow. What is Tech Amnesty?
Well, it's a partnership we're doing with a nonprofit called One Northwest. Their mission is to support local environmental nonprofits.
Okay.
So they provide technical resources and expertise to these nonprofits. And then we're doing this as a benefit for them. So it was actually Tech Amnesty is a word or phrase coined by Dean Erickson at One Northwest. He came up with it as we were kind of bannering and talking about this idea. And we both thought it was a great name, great idea. And so 15% of the gross proceeds of the fees that we charge today all go directly to them. So that's what we're doing.
Wow. Okay. So let me get this right. You're helping me because you're taking care of my planet. You're emptying out buildings. You're getting more space. You're sorting out stuff. Things are going back to the community. And you're helping nonprofits.
Yep.
Glenn. Nice work, man.
All right.
Nice
thank work. You. Thank you for coming down.
Wow.